Today I'm going to draw a horror clown head. I'll draw the top of the head there. Zoom in slightly. Start to mark in the hair. I want there to be this big central piece there, and then these two bits at the side. Just keep them as fluffy pieces for now, you know, and just move on to the next bit. Obviously there's going to be a nose there. It's going to be cheekbones there. I'll give him big ears. That's quite scary actually. Hope you're not too scared. Yeah. But yeah, I really want to add some more clown drawing videos, because I really like drawing them. And we'll give him a grin soon. Like that, but he's got teeth. Sketching bottom teeth, really mismatched teeth. Just try and sketch them in. Slightly smaller, just to match the other one slightly. Just give him clown-like eyebrows way up there, just for fun. When drawing any face like this, it's always best to try and add as many details as you can, because when it comes to the inking stage you can always knock them out and, you know, draw less if you want to. But I always draw quite a few details. I think it's time to draw a bit more this hair. I think I'll try and make it slightly curly. Weird curly hair. Clown like. When it comes to doing this, you can tidy up a bit. But for now, I just want to Just try and keep it quite loose looking. Maybe some shadow in between there. There's a dark rings around the eyes. So I've got our initial pencil sketch nearly sorted. I can start to ink this now. That's the ink pen, it's behind me here all along. Looking for that. I've got the Copic multi-liner here. In fact, I'll get the Copic brush pen just to do these bits around the eyes. So when drawing these horror clown heads, it's always best to try and have the eyes staring, you know, right in the middle of the eyes, round about, or thereabouts. Keep it all rough, you know, the main shapes. But it's not like a normal clown, as you can see. Some kind of demon clown or something. Keep the darker bits around the edges so it helps just give it a bit of definition, you know, more close together with the dark areas and less on the top, and so it just creates a bit of volume there. Hairstyle, innit? I'll be scared by the hairstyle more by this clown, I think, than the rest of the other features, I think. I'll be like, whoa, Jesus, stay away from me, clown. Get to the hairdressers. We just draw the outline of the ears. Some of the lines in between, but I can thin them out with a thin ink marker. From that nose, so I'll do some stippling there just to show that there is some more darkness around the nose there. Keep using that marker, you'll just become used to using them all the time. A mix of different thicknesses always works on a drawing, so that's why I try and mix it up nowadays. Eyebrows. These teeth in now. Details of the gum. He's got no actual lips there, it's just got like teeth. So that always works quite well. Proper horror clown. Some more extra added details. The ends in the eyes. There. Get the thicker pen now. Try and fill in a bit of black in the teeth. Try not to go over the teeth. You can clean it up with a thinner ink pen near the you know where the teeth lines are, but nice bit of black ink just helps separate all them teeth, like on many other drawings I've done. You just take the time just to go over, you know, them white areas like I'm doing now. It just neatens it all up. If I'd have left it, it would just look a bit more sketchier than, you know, any other of my drawings. Because I'm like trying to be quick about it because I'm sort of on video being timed. Against the clock sort of thing. And so really we've got our horror head there. Quick sketch. Yeah. I could go on and add more details to it and I probably will do in time, but it's a basic horror clown head. So, I'll see you in the next video. Cheers now.